Shanghai GDG is a very interesting developer community.
I'm glad somebody has asked this question.
This is where the magic happens.
This is primarily a question and answer show. So if any of you out there would like to ask questions.
Hello, and welcome to another episode of GDLIL, GDL Israel. Today we are going to speak about HTML5, some cool new things that we see today. And of course, we're going to deep dive into web workers and why this HTML5 API lets you use multi-thread in the browsers is very great way to actually improve your performance and make sure that your web apps and websites are working better and utilize the quad core, 8 core, or any other number of cores that the devices that your browser is running on. So without further ado, let's jump and see some code. Let me share my screen with you. And yeah, hopefully if I'm jumping, yeah. So for the ones that don't know, let me just open it and make it a bit bigger, but on this spot, so it will be here, right here, let's make it bigger. So at ido-green.appspot.com, you could see all the sources and everything that we will cover today. And as you saw probably, the first screen that I shared with you was a post that I wrote actually almost now a year ago about big data and web workers. And the promise or the big thing there is that today in modern browsers and more browsers are actually implementing this important HTML5 feature, allowing us to work with big data. And when I'm saying big data is with half a smile, because it's not teras, but still few megs that up to now, when we wanted to move them with post message to the window object or to the worker object, it was quite hard. Luckily, today with HTML5, we could use transferable objects and do that very, very quickly. This is a good link to start with, which is the spec of transferable object. And basically, from a macro level, what we have here is just moving and not a copy operation. So we're moving a pointer and we're getting a boost in our performances. In this specific case, specific example, you can see that basically what we have here is a way to use transferable object or not to use them, and then we're just seeing what huge difference it's bringing in terms of the amount of seconds that it will cause our worker to get the data, crunch it, and return it back. This is the example page, and as you could see here on ido-greenappspot.com/html5webcomp. This is part of a presentation, and basically when we're running the test, you could see here that it's taking it 2 milliseconds on average, maybe 3-4. Let me make it a bit bigger so it will be easier to see. Now if you'll take the exact URL here and basically copy it to all the browsers that are not supporting transferable objects, you'll see a number here that is at least 50 times higher. In most of the cases that I've checked, it was around 150, 160 milliseconds. So it's quite nice to see that today we have a very efficient way to work with web workers. Because, of course, the bottleneck wasn't in the CPU or the work that the worker itself is doing for us, but more in the way that we are transmitting big data, again, with a half a smile, to the worker and back to our web app. Here is another link. Basically, I wrote a book with O'Reilly about web workers, but all the examples of the book are, of course, free for use on GitHub, and you could see it here. And basically get and fork all the different examples. The ones that we will focus today are just two quite nice examples that I wanted to share with you. So let's go here and try now again to share the example page. It's right here. The reason I just switched Windows is that because I wish to show you this example on Chrome Canary. For the web developers here that aren't using Chrome Canary when they are developing, I highly advise you to try it. It's a great way to stay up to date with all the new features that you have in Chrome and that you will see in the stable version after 6 weeks, more or less. Because as you all know, Chrome is out there every six weeks with new features and improvements to its speed, security, and simplicity, of course. And here in Chrome Canary, we have several things that are new, but basically harnessing us with better ability to debug web workers. As you can see here, let me just load this page from the start. What we have here is a web worker that we will use in order to calculate pi. And as you can see here, I can choose the amount of cycles that I wish to do and then start the worker. And I hope that you could all see now that what I have here is basically a from DevTools. I see that you don't see because you see the main page. Let me again share with you the right window. And let's see here. Yeah, Chrome DevTools. So the nice thing here is what you see here is basically the Chrome DevTools that you all know and I hope love. But here, the main difference is that, as you could see now, we are in the example pi.js, which is our worker. And what I did is that I just check one checkbox to make sure that on the start of everything, our web workers DevTool window will be open for us. And then we'll be able to go step by step and just use the debugger as we like. As you can see here, I have an event listener, and I'm getting two messages, the start and the stop buttons. So in this case, since you're all aware that I clicked on the start button, if we just release it, you see that I'm holding now on the post message of the start case, and now we could go case by case and just have our calculation. You could see here that I have the right number with me, and now basically I just need to communicate it back to the parent, which is the index HTML5 app. I just release it, and now let's switch again to the main window. Here it is, and as you could see here nicely, let me make it a bit bigger, not this one, but rather this one. So I got the messages, as you could see here, in the dev tool, and we got the amount of cycles that we are going to run, and then we got our answer back. And as you could all see, we have here the right answer. And maybe we should step one or two steps back, and just let me share with you, let's close this one, when we're talking about web workers, what are the most basic fundamental components that we're working with and we want to see in a web worker. So let me here just go, yeah. So let's do it again, and we'll just load a new screen that I'll share with you. And we'll see what are the most basic components of web worker and how we could work with them. If people are joining, please just put on mute. It would be great. Okay, so let's take the yes. So what we have here basically, um, Canary, let me take and show you this quick example. I hope you all see my window. It's going to be quite quick. We'll reach to the part that we want to show. Yeah. So basically, when we're talking about web workers, we have three elements that we want to take a note. First is in our one-page app, in our mobile web app, in our web app, we want to be able to get out of the realm of the single thread that our JavaScript engine allows us to do and just start a new thread on the side, crunch some number there. It could be 3D matrix calculation. It could be route calculation on maps. It could be anything that right now you're doing with hacks of set timeout or things like that, and you just want to purely do it off the main thread so it will not interfere with the DOM, with the window that you are showing the user. So the user won't see any slagginess, and everything will work really nice and fast. So what you need to do in your index.html is just call your worker with this constructor. And basically, you're just pointing to a JavaScript file that contains all the logic that the worker itself will run. After that, the only two other things is to create the communication channel with the worker. So one will just create a new event listener and just hook it, so we'll be able to send some commands or data to the worker and, of course, get back from the worker information. In this example, I'm just sending at the beginning some settings, so some initialization settings, and that's it. In the worker itself, what we need to do is, of course, add the event listener, so we'll have the post message channel with our master or parent, if you will. Then, of course, have a main function of doing some work. And here I just choose to put as an example a JSON piece, so it's quite powerful. The specification in a worker doesn't allow you to do everything that you could do today in the window or the main DOM object, but it's good enough and you could do quite a lot of things with it. One of them is just leveraging the power of JSONP and just import scripts from the outside world and just register a callback to them to handle the work. And in our case, we just choose this amazing generic name, handle work, and here we'll just do the work when we're getting the results from the callback, and in this case, post the message back to the parent, so here it will get it again, and it will do the right things with it, probably communicate it back to the user with some DOM manipulation that reflect the calculation that we did in our worker. Few things that are quite nice to note and are quite important, actually. Let me first just remove this image that with my big screen doesn't work well here. And now when we removed it, yeah, we could focus better on what we're doing here. So first and foremost, you want to use Modernizer. Modernizer is a great framework that basically allow you to make sure that you have web worker in the browser. How you do that? After you are basically import the Monetizer library, you just set up if statement. And with this if statement, everything that you'll do after that, if it's true, of course, letting you know that you do have web workers in the specific browsers. How Modernizer look like? Well, you can find it on GitHub, and you could check a lot of great things that Paul Irish, Bruce Bowman, and other great contributor are saying about it. The other big and major thing about it is shared workers. Shared workers is basically a web worker that could be shared between several windows or tabs. So you can think of it as a one point of communication with your local database, your local IndexedDB, or maybe if you have a database in the cloud or some other logic that you want one place to communicate with, that's the right location to put it. And the great things about it is that if you'll see when I'm opening the Chrome DevTools, very easily I could go and make sure that I will be able to debug workers. And how? With that. On source tab, as you saw what I did, I just went to the source tab. Down here, we have workers. So like we could put, like we're putting any other breakpoints, we could just mark this checkbox and pause on start. And then, as I said, shared worker will be inspected in the task manager, but regular workers, like the one I showed, will be just stopped here. And that's basically the example that we start our GDL today with. What else we could say about it? Yeah, of course, we have a link here to the worker itself. And when I clicked on it, basically, I opened another window that let me debug it. And let's close this one. And of course, you could have a link here with all the examples that we're going on. And I showed you it's all on GitHub for free, of course. So I think that's it. I see that we have a few questions. If someone would like to ask a question, this is the right time. Great. So if there are no more questions, let's see if we have some more things that I wanted to share today. Let me share the screen one time more. One more time, please. Let's see here. Yeah, this is the right one. And this is the example of the transferable object. This is the location of the web workers examples. Let me make it a bit bigger. And the easiest way to do it is just, And of course, you could see and read more thoroughly what we covered today on my blog, greenido.wordpress.com. Let me put it just here so you'll all see it. It's right here. So if you'll search web workers on this blog, you're probably going to see all the different things that you could do with web workers. And until next time, be strong and safe. And next week, we are going to have here an AngularJS specialist, Shai Resnick, that will share with us some of his thoughts. So you are most welcome to join us in our next GDLIL. It will be on next week at 2 Israel time. And until then, see you later. Bye-bye, guys.